Today, we will see how to make a smart motion detection camera using the ESP32-CAM. This project will take a photo when it detects motion and send that photo to your Gmail. You can see, as soon as I move my hand near the motion sensor, the camera will capture a photo and send it to Gmail. First, open your browser and go to google.com. Now look at the top right corner, you will see your Gmail profile picture. Click on that picture. Then click on Manage your Google account. Now you are in your Google account settings. From the left side menu, click on Security. Here, we will make some changes. Now scroll down. Click on two-step verification. If it's OFF, you need to turn it on. Now, Google will ask you to enter your Gmail password again. Type your Gmail password and click Next. After that, a new page will open. Here, you need to turn on two-step verification. Google will now ask for your mobile number. Select your country and then enter the phone number that you want to use to verify your Gmail account. You will receive a code by SMS. Enter the code to verify. Once done, go back to the security page. Now scroll down on the same security page. You will see an option called App Passwords. Click on App Passwords and a new page will open. If you don't see the App Password option, don't worry. I have given a special link in the video description. After turning on two-step verification, just open that link and it will directly take you to this page where you can create your app password. Now type a name like ESP32-CAM and click Generate. Google will show you a 16-character password. Copy this password. You can now paste it into your Arduino code. Before we upload the code to ESP32-CAM, let's first understand what this board is. ESP32-CAM is a small but powerful development board. It has a built-in camera, Wi-Fi, and Bluetooth, and a microSD card slot. But here's the important thing, ESP32-CAM does not have a USB port, so you cannot connect it directly to your laptop to upload code. That's where the MB Programmer comes in. MB Programmer is also called FDDI Programmer, USB to TTL Converter. This small board has a USB port and it helps you upload code to the from your computer. It also gives power to the ESP32-CAM. Now let's open the code. At the top of the code, you will see three lines starting with hashtags. These are the libraries used in the project. Select each line one by one and copy them. Next, go to the Tools menu in Arduino IDE and click on Library Manager. In the search bar, paste the library name you copied. If it shows Remove, that means the library is already installed. If it shows Install, then click on Install. Do this for all three libraries. Now scroll down in the code. You will see Wi-Fi SSID. Here you need to type your Wi-Fi name. Below that, type your Wi-Fi password. Under that, it says author email. Enter the Gmail address where you generated the app password. Below that, it says author password. Here you need to paste the Gmail app password you copied earlier. Remember to remove all spaces from the password. After that, go to the Tools menu in the Arduino IDE. From Boards, select ESP32. Then scroll down and choose AI Thinker ESP32-CAM. Now again. And go to Tools and select the correct port. Finally, click the upload arrow at the top. Your code will now upload to the ESP32-CAM. After uploading the code, we remove the MB programmer from the ESP32-CAM. The MB programmer is only used to upload the code. Once the code is uploaded, only the ESP32-CAM board works in the project. We will give power to the ESP32-CAM directly from a 5-volt external power supply. This way, your project will run simple, safe, and stable. After completing all the connections, I will use a DC buck converter to give power. I have set the output of the buck converter to 5 volt DC. You can also use any other 5 volt supply if you want. Now let's see the demo. But before that, I have one small request. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Thank you. Here I have kept my Gmail open. This is the same Gmail ID that we used in the code. As soon as I move my hand in front of the motion sensor, the camera flash will turn on. The camera will take a photo and send it to Gmail. You can see that the message has arrived on Gmail. I will open it now. As you can see, the photo shows my mobile on the tripod because I was recording the video.